Hello and welcome to the final day of judo action from the 30th Universiade. We've seen 32 medals handed out already. The final eight will be won today in the team. Let's turn our attention now to the men's team final. It's Korea against Russia. Korea 2, Russia 2. One final match to decide it, and it's the heavyweights, the over 90 kilos. Ruslan Shakhbazov of Russia up against Min Jong Kim of Korea.
The two real heavyweights fighting here.
Well, the Russian won gold in this weight category earlier on in the week. Can he now win gold for his team?
Well, both are left-handed fighters. And both have classic lapel and sleeve grip, trying to keep each other at a distance. The Russians leaning a little bit.
We were both impressed, weren't we, by this weight category and by how agile and nimble and fast the heavyweights have been in this Universiade.
That's right. They surely don't disappoint.
Just update you on the other bronze medals. Japan 1-0 up against Germany at the moment, and it's 1-1 between Brazil and Azerbaijan. 2-2 between Korea and Russia for the gold and silver. All square, penalty apiece.
You can see Kim is trying to generate movement with his left hand on the lapel. And it's a really good way, and he's trying for that Seonagi, Morote Seonagi. Oh, and here he is, so agile for a big man, just dropping under beneath his opponent like that. We have seen in the earlier days, Kim can really pull off the drop Seonagi, which is not very common for players of this weight category. And that's what makes him dangerous. And Shakhbazov is a very powerful player.
And the Japanese picks up a second penalty. Sorry, the Korean picks up a second penalty.
Pressure is on Kim now, do all the attacks. Shakhbazov can be a big thrower, takes his time, sets up his throws, waits for his opponent to make a mistake.
Real atmosphere in the hall now, as this gold medal goes down to the wire. The Korean attempts a throw. Oh. Can the Russian get him in a hold?
Kim's desperately trying to get out of that, and he manages to flip onto his belly. Oh, he did a really good Seonagi attempt, dropping between his opponent's legs, but Shakhbazov has such a good defense and posture that he was able to stop that and almost pin Kim.
Kim, just 18 years old, already a cadet world champion, former junior Asian champion, so he's used to performing in front of a loud crowd.
A Tomonagi, wow, what a lift. That was a well-timed.
And you need it. Real strength in your legs to do that.
And good timing too for players of this weight. That was completely unexpected from Kim.
So a penalty for passivity to the Russian. So we really are square with the clock counting down to the final 30 seconds of the final fight to decide the team gold medal in the men's section. Two penalties apiece, 2-2 the score.
I can see the Russians pushing forward and Kim tries very hard to generate movement, which is nice to see, instead of just blocking his strong opponent. He's working with his arms and his shoulders to generate some reactions.
And we have the gong. We're into golden score. No late controversial throw at the end of time this time. Four fights to get to this final, and it's come right down to golden score of the final fight of the final match.
You can see Shakhbazov is really trying hard to dominate his Korean opponent, and Kim is not letting that happen. We're going to see one of these players trying a big technique at this point.
They'll be aware they've got to pull something out of the hat now.
Morote Sionagi from Kim, and straight away to a strangle from Shakhbazov. Well defended by Kim.
And tiredness will start to creep in as well.
Definitely.
This category were the first category to fight on Thursday, but they will have also been involved in the men's open category yesterday, so they've seen plenty of action to get to this point.
Well, I think the referee is going to give out penalty.
Oh, is this going to be decided on a penalty? It'd be a shame if it was, but I think you're right. The referee's looking over at the jury. You're watching it on video. They're watching it back. And it's a third penalty, an elimination for the Korean Min Jong Kim. Russia have been given this fight.
Well, Kim got a penalty for holding up the same side without generating any kind of attack. And I think he was trying to explain to the referee.
So Kim complains, but Shakhbazov wins. And Russia win the men's team final 3-2, with the deciding fight being decided on penalties. Ruslan Shakhbazov wins the gold for Russia, his second gold of this Universiad. And so Russia can now celebrate their third gold medal in the judo this Universiad. Okay, so smiles all round in the crowd, and the judo is over for the 30th Universiad from Lincoln Hahn. Thanks very much for joining us. It's been a fascinating insight into the judo. And from me, Alec Wilkinson, it's goodbye for now.
Thank you.